The space for political dialogue in Egypt is taken up very much by one man. Field Marshal Abdel Fattah al-Sisi dominates the landscape, and though he's yet to declare his candidacy, his supporters call him the nation's only hope. For Strong Egypt party founder Abdelmanim Abu Fatuha, that sense of all or nothing sums up what's wrong with the country 3 years after a popular uprising.
A revolution took place and the Egyptian nation offered martyrs for the sake of having real elections.
Abu Fatuha believes the current military-installed government has made real elections impossible.
In the name of fighting terrorism, it exercises oppressive acts against the political opposition, and we hope we succeed in our efforts with all different sides at dialogue.
Inclusiveness is something Abu Fatuha says he tried in the 2012 election. A former Muslim Brotherhood leader, he presented himself as a moderate independent, attracting everyone from students and housewives to ultra-conservative Salafists, all while boasting an unveiled Marxist woman as a political advisor. He saw no such inclusion in the presidency of the race's victor, former Brotherhood colleague Mohamed Morsi. Abu Fatuha was among those who last year called for early elections, but he rejected the military's forcing Mr. Morsi out.
It claimed it had to do this to avoid a civil war. But what is happening in Egypt now is a civil war. All the killings that occurred, the conflict and polarization that exists.
Some see the problem as a lack of seasoned politicians to face up to the problems. Abu Fatuha, for example, is an accomplished physician, but in the last campaign lacked what many felt was a credible economic plan. Political analyst Hisham Qasim, who thinks Abu Fatuha would only gain single-digit support, also finds fault with a public, even one which overthrew long-serving autocrat Hosni Mubarak, sadly comfortable with strongman leadership.
When you come out of authoritarian rule, you're always stuck with a whole batch or lot of hypocrites. Okay? And if Sisi tomorrow decides I'm not running, they're going to look for the runner-up and move their guns there or their forces.
If so, they may have options. Retired Armed Forces Chief of Staff Sami Anan has made plans to enter the race. Abu Fatuha blames not just military figures, but also the stubbornness of Egypt's other political parties.
They were not trained on dialogue, argument, on accepting the other, and on gaining something and losing another, and that this is the nature of democratic politics.
Even this potential bridge candidate has given up on the possibility of give and take in a country he now calls a republic of fear. Abu Fatuha is refusing to run. Elizabeth Arrett, VOA News, Cairo.